Yes, my people, I greet you. I salute you very, very well. Thank you so much for joining me. Please, if you are joining, I appreciate you. I just want to, you know, appeal to you. Let's share this broadcast. This one broadcast, I want us to help me share so I can go around. I have one subject matter. It's going to be very brief that I'm going to try to quickly address because, of course, as you see, an error left unrefuted leads to intellectual immorality. Thank you very much, Chris Osaigi. I see you all the way from Michigan. God bless you, my friend, for joining the broadcast. Thank you so very, very much. Please, let's share the broadcast. Let's get some numbers together. Let's keep sharing. What is the issue? I just want to set some records straight. It's important I do so right now because some things are beginning to, like, you know, get out of their hand, and I want to deal with them and leave them in the board. I've been receiving calls, you know, a lot of calls, messages, people expressing different opinions because of this issue of this artifact and all of that, and warnings, insults, different kinds of things from different persons and all that. And I have maintained one posture with each of them. And that posture is a posture of, look, you've said all you need to say, okay? All we need is peace. And I want to make it very clear here, you know, to everybody. I know that, you know, beyond what we have seen, okay, some persons who appear to have been very much disenchanted or who don't like the governor, okay, they want to make sure that, oh, this matter is... But each time I've come out to talk about this matter, I have channeled my energy towards, you know, looking for the peace in this matter, looking for the progress in this matter. Now, the issue is this. I want to say this straight. As I stand here, okay, I stand strongly with the palace, the position of the palace. Now, what I do not do is to hang the governor of Edo State, which a number of persons have been doing. It's an opportunity to bring the governor, you know, down, kill him, do this, do that. Now, that is what I have not done. And that is why many of these calls are coming. Many of these talk here, talk there are coming. Okay, I'm on Oba Nedo Atokpe. Each time I've made a broadcast since the Oba of Benin spoke, the word of the Oba of Benin has never been a contention. My word had always been that we must unite as a people to get, you know, the best out of this situation. The government of Edo State must do what is right for us to, you know, get peace and progress out of this matter. Now, even your Monoba himself did say that where there is no peace, progress is difficult. At the end of the day, this whole program is about getting progress for Edo State. And that is where, you know, that is where I've always leaned towards. Now, I want to make something really clear that everybody needs to understand. Because we don't need to get it twisted. Do I support the governor of Edo State? I am an ardent supporter of the governor of Edo State. In fact, I am an unrepentant supporter of the governor of Edo State. I am, without apologies, an unrepentant supporter of the governor of Edo State. As at today. Now, if you don't know that, know that. Now, Am I biased? Is my support for the governor making me biased about this situation? It's not. Because I must establish that my support for the governor of Edo State stems out of my very strong belief that the governor of Edo State, based on all he has promised, publicly and privately, is set on a mission to set things right as far as Edo State is concerned. I grew up in that state. I check my age right now. I am in the neighborhood of 50. Now, I look back and I look at the state where I grew up, from where I grew, where many of us have experienced, we are still experiencing. We look back and since when we were born to date, some of us have been privileged to have gone beyond the shores of Nigeria, seen some other societies. You know, we have been privileged to have seen some other countries and all of that. And what we have at home definitely could be better. Could be better. You know, and that is true matter. And so that is actually, you know, the base of my support for this governor. Now, we must not understand, we must equally understand, like I do very much understand, that this issue of artifacts, as it were, needs all the cooperation that we can get from every stakeholder to get these things done. Omonoba Nedukwa Bologbolo came out and raised some issues. These issues bordering on the role of the governor on the artifacts matter. Everybody say, oh, this is a sensitive matter. It's a no-go area. It's this, is that, and all of that. It depends on where each person is standing. It is sensitive. There's no doubt about it. But the person that this matter, you know, concerns is an elected governor, elected by the people. To that extent, the matter has come up that has to do with his own role, okay, overtly or covertly, that for many of us, okay, it's not supposed to be. Now the governor, you know, in his wisdom, and that's what many of us are chasing, need to do what is right. In one of my broadcasts, you know, I talked about the governor issuing a statement, and I said I didn't think the governor needed to issue a statement. And the reason why I said that was very clear. I didn't think so because issues have been raised, and of course the matter is raising dust, and I expect that the governor should do the needful by going straight to the palace and of course sort these things out. Let it be that rising from his meeting with, you know, with His Royal Majesty, okay, whatever gray areas appear, okay, would have been sorted and all of that, so that that is what we want to see. That's what we are waiting for. You know, somebody wrote me a text and said, oh, I'm glad that the governor, you know, of course, did issue this statement. Let us wait patiently for the outcome of what the meeting of the governor with the Oba is going to be. And that is what we expect. That is what we consolidate on what is on ground. Because at the end of the day, you know, there's so much that many of us, you know, are we not cowards, you know, deny here and all that. Now, what I will not do, okay, is to join this bandwagon, as it were, many of them everywhere on Facebook. Anybody that is see at all, you know, is standing or with a way of support for the governor, not even the issues or have to do with the palace or whatever, with the government of Obaseki, the person become, you know, a subject of attack. That shouldn't be. That shouldn't be. As far as this matter is concerned, Omonoba Nedukwu Akpolokpolo is our royal father. I am a subject of the palace. The governor is a subject of the palace. You, as an Edo person, you are a subject of the palace. Now, our father has come out to say there are some gray areas, issues concerning one of his children. And the right thing for all of us to do is to urge that child, like even the Omonoba himself did say, that the child, the prayer should be made for the child to know exactly, to retrace his steps. And the most constructive thing for the rest of us to do is to urge that child, okay, to, you know, to retrace steps and get this right. Because at the end of the day, the subject matter is, in fact, beyond the way some of us even look at the issue of the artifacts right now. I am doing very huge study on the artifacts matter, you know, generally right now. I personally am getting a whole I'm being immersed in a whole different world. You understand what I'm saying? About this artifact matter. Because of the identity of the average adult person that is very connected with this artifact and all of that. So, my statement concerning this matter are two. One, to urge the government and the governor of Edo State to do what is right. Two, to ask that we the Edos cannot be divided. We must be together. We must be together, you know, and to chase after peace, to chase after unity, to chase after progress. This is very key. Some of us, some people are very emotional about this, you know, that. I believe very strongly that there are so many things about the state that we need to be emotional about. Governance is one of them. Governance is one of them. The issues with us as a people, as we speak, Amonoba came out, you know, under this administration to ban the issue of CDA in Edo State. He made a statement concerning that. He resented the activities of CDA. The government of Edo State, you know, the government of Edo State facilitated that process, made an enabling law, and for a while, CDA, you know, ceased. Today, what do we have? They are back again in full force. They no longer call themselves CDA. They call them different kinds of names. Okayeli, Okadis, Okada. And yet, the same activity. We should be emotional about that. Because people are buying land three times. People are buying their land being taken over and sold to another person. In this same system that we live in Edo State. So many things are happening and all of that. Now, I come back to the issue of the governor of Edo State. Like I said, I am an unrepentant supporter of the governor of Edo State. I owe nobody no apologies for that. That is very matter. Now, for those who have, you know, making different statements here, making different statements there, I don't know. It's so unfortunate. Probably the way we grew up from where we came from. Okay, it's so unfortunate that we find it difficult to understand that people can support people based on ideology, not because they are expecting anything, any gratification, or because they are being gratified. I don't belong to that class. And that's not matter. I see some people mentioning some figures, some this, some that. Look, take it to the bank. Let anybody come out anywhere and show proof. I owe nobody a dime. I'm not under the payroll of anybody. If there's anything driving me in the things I do or the statements I make, it is that we must forge a formidable front to make our state a better place for all of us. I'm alive today. I've made one statement, you know, publicly a few times to say that probably jokingly, that if I was alive in the time of Obavorane, the white people would not have succeeded. I think the same application applies to now. We live, we are privileged to be alive today and all of that. What are we doing collectively or individually to ensure that, you know, our state is a better place and all that? I stand strongly with that. I want to be emotional about that, you know? And I want to allow time, okay, for us to evaluate what the governor of Edo State is going to do to ensure that this issues raised, the great areas raised, you know, by the palace, he's able to navigate it in a way that at the end of the day instills confidence in everybody. Now, if the governor is to be, attacked, is to be this, to be that, is this, everybody, we need to wait because issues have been raised, whether we like it or not. Obaseki today is not being dealt with like Mr. Obaseki, an individual. There are so many Obaseki. Some of them are even probably chiefs in the palace and all of that. But this particular one, Obaseki is picked out. Why is he picked out? He's picked out, okay, because he is the governor of the state representing the people. To that extent, we as a people, okay, must be able to talk about it in its own light. I was born and bred that way. Now, the statement of Yoruba Benin to the whole world, some part of it bothers me. And this is the truth of the matter. And the only thing that can rest this matter is for the governor to quickly seek the face of His Royal Majesty and as his son to father, sort out this matter. And I said, it is not a matter, somebody called us, I allowed the person, the question I asked the person is this, are you sure there is somebody in Edo State who is a custodian of debt in Oduwoye? Are you really sure? And because at the end of the day, we're not going on, you don't even know whether do we are here or where. Now, I must make this very clear. I don't know how everybody is. Everybody in Edo State has an opinion about this and about every other thing. More than majority of the people don't come out to speak publicly the way I speak. Or the way some other persons speak. And all of that, what some other persons talk about. But the fact that people don't speak, doesn't mean they don't have things in their mind. This is important. For me, at the end of the day, even then, every artifact in Aguankana, okay, there's a strong recognition that where every stakeholder involved need to work together. Naya may we be here or work. And we, the people, must work in that unity. And that is why I strongly believe that the right thing for the governor to do, I'm not carried away by statements. And that's another thing. A statement the governor make, my interpretation of that statement is where it is meant for all the people. To instill confidence in a way in doing the right thing. And the right thing for the government to do is to seek audience quickly with His Royal Majesty. Now make an aware as Obogwale, Adol Honore the matter, make His Royal Majesty understand some of these gray areas, sort out himself and all every other thing, so that there can be this synergy of purpose in all of these things. At the end of the day, many direct road may play women, neither yourself, who is taking your call to call me or coming to my world to come and make some silly statement. Even if they just quickly packed and followed me because they want to be antagonistic. Look, I will not travel the same lane that many of you are traveling. I won't. I will continue to talk about peace, unity, and progress in Edo State. It's ordinary. You understand? I live in a country. I see what is happening in this country. I do go to some other countries around. Even there is no reason why. Emo iya ni mo weva, iya mo weha. Emo yo biya dole weya ye. People use their hands to without being unnecessarily cynical. Now, but trace it back. I'm on the other side of my 40s. Trace it back. Where for Inwe years no he was day the same story in Edo State and in Nigeria, the same story. People are unemployed. There is no, in fact, the cost of living. In fact, people cannot even maintain cost of living. There are no amenities. No, these are things naturally not taken away where a government will provide. These are issues that we should be sensational about. And my support for the government is in the belief where he will travel the right, make the right journey to get these deliverables to Edo State. At least to start from somewhere so that other people coming can take over from there. I heard some people mention me some money, whoa, 800,000, blah, 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 blah. I just laugh. But I'm saying this publicly, if there's any Bono Highway man, I just try to believe where a nice overall they do the things they do because they are convinced about it, not because maybe there's something they're expecting or there's something they're getting from anybody. And that is my own case. Even 800,000 were mentioning a week in there with me, arguing winner. It's almost my weekly wage. I'm not boasting. It's not for my weekly wage. I'm not trying to sound immodest. I like to be as humble as possible. You mentioned 800,000. What are you talking about? 800,000. So, Edo people, I came out to quickly make this report where a matter of Hiana, my stand very affirmatively, is with the palace of the Oba of Edo State. I believe strongly that on no account, overtly or covertly, knowingly or unknowingly, should any subject of the palace, you know, act in a way that is disobedient to the palace. And if there are such misunderstandings and that subject is available and has a chance, the subject must quickly make sure we matter and address it in a way that way. We need peace and progress. The government is an institution, not affecting the life of the people of Edo State. The palace is an institution, a permanent one at that, not affecting the lives of the people of Edo State. So we cannot play any role that a role of love, a role of unity. I want to buy the right, but not be perfect. I want to be big. Honestly, in a way, I salute, you know, the palace. I salute the palace because where, you know, they tell Omoma Ladiado Guakan some of these issues no raise. My idea, I had made one broadcast when they were even shut up. I had made that break broker because they appear to become rumor mongers and all of that. We were hearing too many things and all that. You know, but eventually the palace came out, spoke. We now knew okay, it mattered so. And I thought that the reasonable thing is to follow the steps of the palace. And I said, well, never have anybody connected, near fall in line. Not to kill anybody, not to castigate anybody. Not to create so many unnecessary debates around this thing. If the Maria expects that Manivia does that well, okay, the governor takes a step, do what is right to be done. Whether we like it or not, there are certain arguments that we cannot even make anymore. You understand, Emenania? It can artifacti kekba, it is known to the world. Everybody knows artifacti kekba. I made a broker say that I have done some research into these things, but throughout last night I was still researching, trying to look into some of these things. As I'm doing the research, even Obuna gave me Orion, I was really pained in my heart how these people in the West, you know, the role they played, you know, to deny us some of our own identity and all of that. And how essential it is. I mean, women, we need to get united to get these things back. I mean, at some point I'm going to be making statement to address the British authorities publicly to make a case for why they need to ensure women they return those artifacts to where they took it from. So at the end of the day, all the other decisions, knowing concerning if you have a fair Naruto, I'm very sure where. If the government of Edo State is able to do the right thing with humility and everything and all of that. I mean the Omonoban Edo wants the progress of his people and all of that. And I'm sure that there can be a synergy that can come out of that place that will ultimately benefit everybody. Or more time, or when you do the right thing, everybody will benefit. Not just those in government or those in the palace, but every Edo person. All Yasigbe. On every Nigerian. And at the end of the day, it is something that nobody said to be catapulting man on the global map and all that. So, for those who are trying to misconstrue or not unnecessarily, some people have impervious ears, you know, you say a word, they hear a different thing. Well, I won. Okay? I make a humble appeal. Nobody should, you know, twist my word, you understand, and misinterpret my word, okay? And I stand to reaffirm where I stand with the position of the Omonoban Edo. I stand to continue to make the call that the governor needs to do what he needs to do concerning the matter raised. You know, because at the end of the day, is the governor of Edo State is a subject, you know, it's a subject of the palace like the rest of us are. But what I will not do is to call for him to die. What I will not do is to stand publicly to begin to throw some words name. Some people are already, you know, throwing and all that. Some of these things may not be unconnected with what may be a mere election. Look, election brother, if any contest election were two private Edo indigens. It's done. So now, you understand it, so maybe this caller is because of this. Hello. Hello? Irelan, are you calling to contribute or you don't? Okay. Yes, yeah, Minuta.
To be honest, it can put a idea, my brother, that trusting in the government setup can be concerned of our father.
Yeah.
Mama did wrong with this intention.
Yeah. You are right. Absolutely. I agree with you. Yes. Wesley, you are me. Thanks for your call, Wesley. So, like I said, my people, while I will, you understand me? So, now I feel me, so even by raw, my setting, I'm not by raw, no setting the, you know, the door. No. We will not just oppose the word of the Oba against anything. I have maintained that. So not allow war. If I even insist, we the people, you know, we need unity. We need it for everything. Because this one wrote on Ania. All the face now the bearer. The act Guanania. The whole world has been centered around artifact. There are critical aspects of governance that we need to be beaming searchlight at. We need to be looking at. We need to be holding the government accountable, you know, for critical aspects of governance. Within this last couple of weeks, not everybody. There are those, really. You understand, Nania? We cannot forget those things. I am an unrepentant supporter of Obaseki. But the reason for my supporting Obaseki is because I believe strongly where he's the best man right now to set things right as far as governance is concerned in Edo State. And for me, it is. I am watching the governor. I'm watching the things. The governor will not get some okay. It's so raw that I believe where, okay, can only day, no, the pace will get set. So there are some approach to some things that okay, maybe this one should have been better. But I don't matter is that way. If there are three different governors approaching the same things, they are probably going to approach these things differently. And so we will wait for some period of time. I said evaluate, you know, what the governor has done, what he has not done right now, and all that. So, but a matter of fact, our own interest not be permanent is the interest of those states. And the report of the time will be that there are no permanent friends, there are no permanent enemies. What we have is permanent interest. And everybody must understand one thing, okay? A supporter in me, if I give you my support, it's unconditional. May support because maybe I'm in the expert, or when I'm convinced to support you, you have my support. I will take a bullet for you. So do not sit out there thinking we may be, there are people who do what they do because of their own personal conviction, and I belong to that class. Understand me, Nania? I'm not based in Benin. But I can tell you where. There are people in Nigeria there. Without sounding immodest, they don't even know what is happening as much as some of us do because we pick interest in those things. Follow and chase after them. So don't write on my word, but tell me 200,000, tell me 800,000. Please, Wawa CAU. If anybody thinks we may be over here, let the person come out and talk to women. If not, I have a comrade bad discuss, not concerning this thing. I don't owe anybody no explanation whatsoever, I swear. And whatever I'm doing is unconditional. It's not because I'm an expert or you know, I'm in a not even nothing. Okay? But don't know where if you have to answer the question, we have anyway. If you are a Benin person, what I'm doing is because of you. Because of the average Edo person, because of Edo state, so that we have a better state. That's the motivation. You know, and I'm satisfied and glad to continue to make my own contribution. So if you are there, you want to be emotive or emotional about something, and not, there are so many things to be emotional about. There are so many things not in place in Edo state. So many. Any bugbe that we can actually be emotional about to find answers for. And let allow the passage of time and the wisdom of the government of Edo state to deal with issues raised at the palace. Anyhow, I think courses will be received. Okay, last night he had the to the extent that some friends of mine, people are beginning to call friends of mine to antagonize them. I looked back like, what have I really done, really, you know, in all of this, other than to speak the truth to what is happening. But I'm not barren you. So let everybody keep his peace. And I will insist on a last note, we have a bigger picture. And that bigger picture is Edo people must be united. And some people called me, a group of official people called me. They were with one person who is from, I didn't even say if it's from a banker. They tell me where they don't like the way things are being handled. And that we're just making this situation look like it is only Benins that are in Edo state. It's only Benins. That this everything is about the Benins. Well, they said a lot of things. You know, they understand a plateau, yeah? And all that. So, somehow, we probably have not created enough balance, you know, to reflect it where Edo state is for all Edo people. The Benins, the Issacos, the Ishans, the Igbankes. You know, we must understand, you know, that. IT Edo, we are all involved. And I try to make that case, you understand that. So, there is nobody, I'm sure, making that case too, where there is nobody that is making any matter, you know, just the Benins. You know, every matter we have on the table is a matter affecting the entire Edo state and even beyond. And, you know, so, our election, like, I like what Moses Dokbolo just said now. Thank you, Moses. Election don't finish, but some people don't want rest. We understand that some people are trying to politicize the matter. Some of people will not feel like make Obaseki become governor. You understand? We understand. Some people called me. In fact, somebody wrote me a message. You know, I checked the wall of the president and I found out, okay, this person has never been for the governor. So I understand so where that is coming from. But look, man, we must all come together. That don't do you. Because if you have actually had a genuine interest to govern Edo state, you don't win. Your interest to make Edo a better place must be constant, should remain constant. So should your supporters interest. So I support that the governor of Edo state be criticized, but let's do the criticism in a constructive manner, not in a way that may be bewa, you know, and all that. So it shouldn't be like that. And I will say this publicly. I hope that the governor gets the message. The governor himself should check those he's working with directly. Directly. Because Osaiba no oyegbena yo ne ali lo wakon. Eba ni atoni se. Oyegbena yo yekun ne ali lo wakon. You know, it's important. But the governor check him and even legayeni and lili mwina. And all that. Because some people that may come in the Bible with me, advisor, I imagine, and stuff like that, they may actually not have your good interest at heart. But the body has a web tabu men was a quell hui. And yes, sick me no the can my artifact, my said dollar nyaku kuiro. So imagine I don't have to know the right things, including the government of those states. They should do what is right. But for we the people, maniware the coco below where walla. We are not enemies. We can't be. As an Edoma, you are my brother. You are my sister. We must stay united. Irrespective of the things that appear to want to divide us, there is a common purpose, a common focus. Even if we are truthful to ourselves. I love that Edo become like London, like New York, like any of those places. It can be. It can. It takes the people to make it happen. It takes the will of the people to make it happen. So walawo, let's make way. You know, walao. So on a very public note, I stand here to say that I stand with the Palace of the Oba of Benin. I stand with the Obonoba Negbe, His Royal Majesty Oba Ewa the Second, and I stand too with the Governor of Edo State, and I enjoin him to do what is right for the interest of the generality of Edo people. So on that note, my people, I want to say a very big thank you. Please help me share this broadcast. No be legal. Let everybody know. And for those who are calling, who are writing this, I will not travel the lane, particularly when you are writing a tiebo, you are calling a tiebo. Well, okay, Damien, we're 11 of my ye as a people. We are not living in primordial times. This is not 100 years ago or 200 years ago. This is 2021. My meaning, I think we, as a people, we need to be a lot more focused on those things that we have as our collective progress. A lot more. Because at the end of the day, there is nobody that has monopoly of anything. Error. Everybody. This is the truth of the matter. You know, so I respect everybody. I pray God all the time to be guided to remain as humble as possible. But the focus of talking about the progress and unity of Edo State, of Edo people, I will not stop. Nobody can intimidate me to that level. I will continue, because probably this, it is one of the reasons why I'm born. You know, I don't, everybody must have a purpose. It is one purpose I found, you know, and I will do everything to continue to promote that purpose. So let us, I don't really like talking about myself, but a broadcaster now, I am poised to doing so, because we are not alone, more than 8 calls, many of which were coming from people very close to me. So, my people, let us nagwale adolo noruwe, nagwale unity noruwe, nagwale peace noruwe, nagwale progress noruwe. If we can transfix our mind to those ones, we probably will get it right and get it better for the benefit of everybody. To be honest, God knows tomorrow, and that is the truth of the matter. It is very likely where, for the rest part of my life, economy of Nigeria may not even affect me. It's very likely. I don't know. You understand, Emenania? And for many Edo people who are actually beyond the shores of Nigeria, my livelihood is not dependent on what happens to Nigeria economy. I'm not there. It's rather painful too. Where so imagine what is send there. £100, yeah, what's in your late 2 weeks or late 1 month? You know, you now have to send that £100, maybe ban me. That is the only area. So it's not even affecting me positively, but negatively. Negatively. So when on why so you TMA 800,000, 200,000, or 1 million, whatever the case is, just go get sense. If 1 million or 100,000 or 800,000 or 200,000 is one big deal to you, I can tell you where a week now we are dedicated with a winner. A week, a weekly wage of women is more than 800,000. So you go and do the mathematics and understand and I convert it. And it's more than that, because where I only a base at the government of the country a base a yone, a base a yone. So when you're talking of so allow war, so whatever I do it, you know, with my heart, because it's believing in it in our way. Not because we may be on the moody from anybody or anybody woman. No. For the interest of the state. Because if I am one, or damn where my even in my year, you know, at this level. And it's so unfortunate. We are not growing, we have not really grown structurally. And as a people, we have not, some of us are not, have not even left, you know, the primordial times. We have not even left, oh, you know, me away, man, 500 years ago, my year, we are still jumping from tree to tree. But my better level here, you know, the life in my year now. My better level here, man. Moses Dukboro, I see you, my brother. God will bless you. Anyhow, Edo people, Nigerians, thank you so very much. Just what I want to say, to reaffirm that my loyalty as a subject is with my father, is with the palace of the Oba of Benin. And of course, my support for the government to do the right thing and keep doing the right things, okay, is equally unflinching. It's unflinching. So, maybe one can matter now, for at least for the time being. But we'll start looking at other matters not concerning governance. We spend too much time on this matter. But we want to hope that let the time come. Maybe you are getting the feeling and the message where what is right has been done. Probably only man is soon very only. If any man is going to the bam wearing so I but right now, every bell that anybody is making is grossly premature, is diabolic, is retrogressive, is unnecessary. On that note, thank you very much. Peace, one love. May God bless Edo State and Edo people. May God bless Nigeria. Long live the Oba of Benin. And of course, may God bless the governor of Edo State. Bye for now. Peace, one love.